Tim, it's your girl Kendall. I am here for another Broadway vlog. Today I am seeing Harry Potter and the Cursed Child parts 1 and 2. Which, if you don't know, Harry Potter is one of the very few Broadway shows where they actually have two parts. So I'm seeing it at 2 p.m. and 7:30 p.m. It's going to be a full day of Broadway, but this is probably the most excited I've ever been for a show. As most of y'all know, I am a huge, huge, huge Harry Potter fan, so I'm so excited to see this. I've read the play and it's amazing, so I'm just so excited to see all the magic that comes.
Yay, I'm here. I got my tickets, obviously got my coffee because it's a long day, and then gotta go wait in this line to get in the theater, but I am literally absolutely buzzing.
My inner Gryffindor is freaking out, I'm so excited. So I just got my photo taken with my house banner because I'm a Gryffindor. I'll show you those pictures, but I'm literally surrounded by like-minded lovers of Harry Potter, and I can't stop smiling because I'm just so excited, and I love Harry Potter, and I'm so excited to see this play because I've read the play. I literally read it in 3 hours. So I just finished part one and I am literally shaking. It ended, I forgot, I read the book like 3 years ago, and it ended in like the most dramatic way. The music was like blaring, there were dementors coming from the ceiling. It was the most amazing thing ever, and then it just ended and it was like to be continued, and the audience erupted, and I cannot wait for 7:30 to see part two. Swoosh and flick! I am literally blown away. I'm just walking trying to figure out where I'm gonna have dinner. It's 5 p.m. The next show starts at 7:30. That was so amazing. The ending like blew me away. The music was so loud, but it was like making your heart hurt. And I know that I got a pin that says keep the secret, so I'm not gonna give anything away, but just like the onstage magic was unparalleled and I am blown away. Like, they use polyjuice potion and they switch so effortlessly, and I'm like, how did y'all do that? But I have to give a shout out to Moni Myrtle because she was amazing. Like, she sounded exactly like the character in the movie, and like everything she did, I was like, yeah, that is something Moni Myrtle would do, which was so amazing. I like forgot so many details, so I'm really, really excited to see part two because I know there's so many things I forgot, and I'm just like, ooh, I'm blown away by these actresses and actors. Okay, my phone was getting really low on battery, so I came in early so I could charge my phone, but look, it's practically empty. Just listen to the music. I might cry. I'm really excited for part two. This is honestly a dream come true. Harry Potter is one of my favorite things in the entire world. Every single person I've met today has been so warm. I think the Potterverse is just so nice, and everyone here is just like so excited to experience this magic. So it's been really great. Expecto Patronum! Single tear was shed. I just, wow. We have one act left. So much left to discover about this show. So I just finished. I love Harry Potter so much. I can't stop praying. It was amazing. And I'm really sad it's over. But hopefully I can see the show again because it's literally amazing. It's hard for me to put into words how much I love Harry Potter, but this show exceeded my expectations. As the button says, I really don't want to give anything away, but the story is better than I remember. Onstage magic is like unparalleled and just blown away, and I'm already ready to reread the books, rewatch the movies, reread the play, and just start it all over again. What a flattering angle! Time to say goodnight to Harry Potter and the Cursed Child part 1 and 2. I considered staying to get my playbill signed, but it is chilly and I am only in a sweater. And you know, I'm content with my experience. I don't need to add or take away anything. It was seriously a magical day. I have to shout out the actor that played Scorpius because like he really led the end of part one and the beginning of part two, and just like his emotional vulnerability was so amazing. Every actor's emotional vulnerability, there were some really sad moments. Like you relive things that you forgot about in the books that you're just like desensitized to, and I cried a lot. It's fine. I also laughed a lot. Like it was really, really funny. They had so many bits. Ron Weasley was hilarious, as expected. So I think I'm just gonna like digest everything on the train ride home, but if this is the end for me tonight, thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see y'all on the next vlog. Bye!